What up, fam? So in this box is my very first Lego set. All right, so let's rewind a little bit. This isn't my actual first Lego set. I lost that. This is a replacement of my first actual Lego set. That's not confusing. In this box is Lego set 6086, Black Knight's Castle. And if you're asking yourself, why do you have a replacement of your first Lego set? Story time. I joined the Marine Corps at 17. I went to Iraq at 18, turned 19 over there. At one point, I was the youngest Marine in all of Iraq back in 2005. In 2004, I had nowhere to live. Like my mom and I were technically homeless for like a couple months. We got kicked out of our house. My mom was fine. She ended up staying with some friends. I didn't. I had nowhere else to go. So I was just kind of kicking it, couch surfing with friends until I left for boot camp. We were homeless by choice. Well, not really. I had to put all my stuff in storage. That means everything that I own from when I was a child all the way up until the end of high school, which included thousands of dollars worth of Warhammer 40K miniatures and figures that I painted, as well as percussion instruments and my really, really old, expensive violin. I had a lot of Lego and all my photos and yearbooks and everything that is irreplaceable. Everything in my life that I owned was in that storage unit. There was no such thing as automatic payments back then in 2004, at least not with this company. So I left my mother 12 checks. And in the last month, or second to last month maybe, she missed the payment. To be fair to her, there was a lot going on. I was coming home from war and she just wanted to make sure everything was kind of taken care of. And this one just slipped her mind. The company tried to contact me, but I wasn't home. I was in Iraq. And they couldn't get a hold of me and they just sold it off to, you know, like Storage Wars, like those type of things. Probably tossed out all my photos, memories, and yearbooks and pictures and videos, which is why now I record and like double save everything to multiple hard drives because I don't want to lose it ever again. I've been on a mission to kind of collect everything that I had at one point. Now that I'm almost complete with Western, I'm now diving back into Castle. Yes, this one came out, I think in the late 80s, if I remember correctly, but it was actually given to me when I was in kindergarten in like 92 for like a secondhand gift. My mom's friend's kid didn't really want it anymore, so they gave it to me. The seller said it was 100% complete. I might be missing a few things. I know I'm missing an axe, which I already have replaced, but here are all the minifigures. Look at that gray. Wow. The base plate. Like, Lego needs to go back to these. These are really, really cool. And then obviously the instructions. It has been almost, if not more than 30 years since I've actually had to build this exact set. And honestly, I don't remember building it the first time. It's a very simple build. A lot of it has to do with very simple technique. I mean, it's also a brick-built castle, which it's already blocky enough. I mean, there really isn't anything out of the ordinary except for a little bit of like angled brick. But aside from the plates that take up a majority of this build, from the front facade, it still does it for me. Like, as much as it isn't as extravagant as the newest castle that just got released, this is still something to look at. Maybe it's the nostalgia, maybe it's not, but ultimately, I love the way this looks. I think the raised base plate though, I gotta give it that. Yeah, I get it. The brick base is something that's more modern and something that's more accepted. But I think a lot of fans will really appreciate the nostalgia of the base plate, but maybe we also have to remember that the base plates themselves aren't really manufactured by Lego. So it is a third-party company that Lego kind of just encompasses in their inventory. So maybe that might be a problem enough as it is. I do know with my experience in trying to collect every single faction for these castle themes is that the white Black Knight, which with the white accents around his armor, is worth a pretty penny. In fact, both of these knights are worth a pretty penny. The other two, not so much. But for the most part, the horse barding and the knights themselves, just to get the entire setup, you're looking at about 80 to 100 some dollars, if that, if they're in pristine condition. Now, the Black Knight's flag, both the small and the large, also run you a pretty penny. They are not easy to come by, hence the price point. But aside from the shields and the printed pieces, a lot of it's pretty easy to just make on your own. There are some building techniques that I would have never thought we would do now, especially with these inverted slopes that are going in the opposite direction as opposed to going the outwards. And although a dollhouse, there are a lot of areas in this castle where you question how a minifigure were to either get up or even stand in that one area. But I feel like things like that wouldn't pass nowadays. This is also a used set, and I was already aware of some of the discrepancies that might have come with it, especially the string that no longer exists on
one of the sides of the drawbridge, but it does come with some pretty cool play features that would exist in a castle, such as the drawbridge, the gate, and this dungeon area, which I feel like is just a necessity for every single castle that is made. There really isn't much for living quarters, but it is what it is. This is what a castle back then would encompass, and I'm not really complaining. It's not really a symmetrical shape, something that's new for, I think, the castles back then. We don't really know what happened to them. They kind of just disappeared. They did go to war with the other two factions and also were also at peace during like the tournaments and stuff like that. I could be wrong about those things, but there's really nothing special to how they look. A lot of their pieces were reused and recycled again with the royal knights, with their torsos, especially with the knight pieces. The dragon shields were used again for the dragon masters that came up like right after them. This doesn't have a Majesto, but it does have a ghost, a glow-in-the-dark ghost. And also a wolf pet. It is the older gray pieces. Nothing's really fragile in here. Nothing really broke. The only thing I'm really concerned about is the horse barding and the minifigs themselves. Everything else is pretty replaceable and doesn't really hurt you too much in the wallet. It does make me appreciate the way Lego does their instructions and building steps, find the pieces and build it, as opposed to going step to bags, which is something that I've been trying to push to Brickmania. I'm like, hey, maybe you guys should do step to bags. Lego doesn't own that license anymore. Yes, that was a thing where Lego owned the licensing to bags and steps.
There was a dark time when Mega Constructs, I think they were still Mega Blocks at the time, did not have numbers on their bags. Or letters. It was just go fish, right? The reason for that was freaking Lego. Because Lego somehow got a design patent on instructions for buildable toys.
Good for them.
That you can follow along with Lego. Numbered Lego. Or lettered bags.
That they is actually, a smart lawyer. That is a smart lawyer.
Oh my God.
Yeah. We need a corner.
I did not know that.
This was my only annoyance. That's because I'm spoiled now, because Lego does make it easier for the builder, make it more an enjoyable experience. But back then, it did bring me back to like trying to figure out where these pieces are. They're not highlighted at all. They're just kind of there, and you got to kind of figure out where they go. And that's probably where a lot of kids back in the day had a lot of extra pieces. All right, so let me know what you guys think. If you made it to me all the way to the end of this video, thumbs up, thumbs down, like, comment, subscribe below, and I'll see you on the next recovery vintage Lego castle video. All right, guys, peace.